To be here on a really exciting day where the news is out that the hospice is saved thanks to a wonderful appeal and, of course, critically, the wonderful generosity of local people across the Black Country. That's what this is all about.
And, of course, you were the patron of the appeal. Obviously, it must be extra emotional for you to now see that it's been saved.
Well, because they kindly asked me to be patron back in the summer of 2019, and it didn't take me a moment to think about it, actually. I just thought, yeah, we're going to do this. This can be done. As I said to you on the phone, it seemed daunting, the amount of money that we got to raise back in 2019, but everyone has stepped forward.
Was it ever in doubt, do you think, that people would,
no.
when they knew about it?
Never, in my mind, it was never in doubt. That's why we need to do it. And so the most important thing that happened was the trustees giving more time for the appeal to really get momentum and therefore raise the money. But I knew it would be done.
And you also did your bit as well?
Yes, I ran the half marathoners and all that. And the other thing, the other run the half marathon, a little bit of fundraising there. But also what we did was a lovely event, was when we did the in conversation with Stephen Knight, of course, and everyone has a view on Stephen and the Peaky Blinders. So yeah, that was brilliant to be able to do that.
Yes. And obviously you're here today, there's lots of smiling faces around. Is that obviously make you quite happy to see
thing
as well?
The thing that's so exciting is just think about what this really means, that children who are either resident, and that's actually a very small proportion, remember. Many, many bigger numbers actually have home provision. People who, at their most difficult time in life, will get something very, very special, indeed unique, provided here. So what this is really celebrating is the fact that provision will go forward.
I'm very emotional today. Try my best not to cry. I think I've put off going into the craft room until everybody's here.
Yeah.
So I know as soon as I walk in there, I know I'm going to be in floods of tears. I apologise in advance. But I'm just absolutely overwhelmed. it's 2 years. Next Wednesday, 6 with Isabella, and to be here today with the sun shining in Acorns, with everybody celebrating the fact that Acorns in the Black Country is saved. It's just phenomenal. It's just Isabella's been guiding everybody throughout all this, and Isabella's shining down on us all today. This is her day. It's not mine. It's Isabella's day today.
And when you found out that, obviously, the craft room, which I understood she loved so much.
She did.
Had been, obviously, named in her honour. Was that, was that quite an emotional
thing? The craft room was a room that Isabella always went straight to when she got here.
Yeah.
It was her escape from her treatment. It was somewhere where she could go and be creative and just forget all the problems and concentrate on making a thank you card for somebody or a painting or a picture for the wall here. And she just got so focused and it just took away any concerns and worries she had about her treatment. There were times that we were here and it was 10:30 at night and I was saying, come on Isabella, we need to go, you need to have some medication, you need to go to bed. And I've got to finish this. For the perfectionist, everything here had to be perfect. That just sent up Isabella. So to know that the room's been renamed in her memory, it's just phenomenal. Absolutely, it's just wonderful.
And obviously, 2 years ago, it wasn't obviously too long since you lost Isabella. That the future of this site was in jeopardy. Well, I know you and Mark obviously did some fundraising events and we've been obviously here. Was that quite tough or were you kind of spurred on by your memory?
Isabella went to a lot of places throughout her treatment. Acorns was always one of those places that I always felt comfort when I came into. And even now, coming back 2 years after leaving her, certain places can evoke certain memories and your senses are heightened when you're walking and you can smell smells that you haven't smelled for some time. But whenever I walk into Acorns, all I feel is just love and warmth and comfort. Isabella's here, she's in the fabric of the place, she's in the walls. It's just Isabella, it's just Acorns, Walsall is Isabella, and that's the way it is. It's been an emotional 2 years. I'm in a different place, I think, emotionally to where I was 2 years ago because we had just lost Isabella, and then it was within a matter of weeks we found out that this place that had supported us as a family so much was at risk of closure. But even in the depths of grief, Isabella was guiding us and she was pushing us to fight for it. And 2 years later, emotionally, I'm in a better place, and that's thanks to the ongoing support that I've had from Acorns. And people don't realise how much that they actually do. It's not just children coming in to the hospice and receiving treatment, it's outreach support as well. And even now, they've supported me with grievance counselling, things that I would never have even thought of. I'm wearing a necklace today around my neck, and it's got Isabella's fingerprints on. In those days where we'd lost Isabella, I would never have thought to have got an imprint of her fingerprints, but Acorns just did that. They gave it to me and said, when you're ready, you can do something with this. And I've now got this done, and I wear it every day. And that's something that Acorns did. So even 2 years on, they're still supporting us as a family, and I'm now talking to you about their ongoing support.
Obviously, glorious sunshine today. You mentioned there it's been symbolic. How have you been?
Feels very symbolic today because we've had a lot of rain and a lot of clouds, and I think we're really excited for Acorns. We're particularly excited for the children and families who use this service, this vital service in the Black Country now, and the children and families that will use it inevitably in the future. We're also really excited for the local community because I think we all need some good news at the moment, and this is the best possible news, and it's happened purely because of the generosity of this wonderful local community.
Was it ever in doubt that you'd raise the money?
Oh yeah, I mean, as Andy said, they were quite long odds. What we were dealing with a very complex picture where at the time we announced the closure, there was uncertainty as regards our national funding from the NHS, some of our local funding, as well as some of our local fundraising. And what we had to do was to find a solution to each of those three things. And in fact, it was I think the reason why it's so nice to have Emma here, who started the petition, is I think it was the level of public concern about the closure of the Black Country's only children's hospice. That if you like, and then the power in which Mark and Jen were able to convey what the service was and what it meant, I think that created the political momentum that led to a better funding settlement for the country's children's hospices. But we still weren't there. What that did is that gave us a bit of time and a bit of space to come to the public and say, look, if you can help us raise this extra money, then we'll get to a place where we feel very confident about the long-term sustainability of the charity. And we do have that confidence now.
And now, obviously, looking forward, I think you mentioned to me before that you're planning on refurbishing the bedroom.
Yeah.
Is that right? Is that what you're focused on at the moment?
You know, we've not been in a comfortable financial position for many years, you know, and rightly we've always prioritised, you know, direct delivery of service. But I think what we've realised now, we've got this fantastic special relationship with our local community and local businesses, that we probably would find support we needed to do some, frankly, very overdue. The bedrooms here are 20 years old, so, you know, I know it sounds... everything Acorns does is about making the best possible experience for children and families. So there are things like putting LED lightings that would project wonderful things onto the ceilings of the hospices, or change the colour of the walls to the... You know, if you have white walls and LED lighting, you can pretty much make what you want to make. We don't have mobile phone USB sockets and things like you start to see as standard. You know, we're in the business of creating home from home and creating the best possible experience for children and for families. So by spending not much money, we think now that we've secured the hospice, then obviously we're... You know, I guess equivalent, if you're thinking about moving home and then you decide to stay put, then you suddenly think, right, well, I'm going to go and, you know, I'm going to get all my decoration done. And I think that's where we are as a charity at the moment. So we'll be, talking to some local businesses and and looking at see what we can do.